temperature's up, the snow has melted, and we're back to sunset pics coming in. No snow there. Kimberly Scott Hale sent this one in. I believe it's from Hale's Bottom, Virginia. Another beautiful pic of the sun setting through the cloud deck. We had some drizzle around this afternoon. Currently, the temperatures haven't strayed too much from their afternoon highs. Greg and Mullins report 39 degrees, and that's the dew point. So there's going to be some fog out there tonight as well. And there's already some reported in Lewisburg at 40 degrees. They might get down in the mid-30s. I don't think anybody's going to get down to freezing tonight, which is good news. But what stands out on our national temperatures? Look down in the deep south. Birmingham, 60. Memphis, 63. That is the air that's streaming our way to Mars. It's already been streaming our way a little bit, but that's also going to provide some fuel for our upcoming cold front, a spring-like system, almost spring-like tonight, right around 50 degrees. Just a few little sprinkles cruising by to the north, and that will continue in the overnight hour with the cloud covers. We continue to get this mild air streaming up all the way from the Gulf. High pressure will start to move off to the east, though, and make way for this, a very potent spring-like system emerging out of the Colorado Rockies, and it is going to follow a track westward and then go across the Great Lakes, but it's pulling up that warm air. We got cool air behind it, then cold air further back. So the clash of air masses is creating quite a ruckus with a cold front, with the thunderstorms erupting on there. As we zoom out and look at the watches and warnings, the tornado watches from the corner of Texas, so right along into Arkansas, right on the border there is a tornado warning. We look further back, we got blizzard watches, warnings, and winter storm warnings. We're not going to get either one of those type of activities. Just an indication that there's a lot of energy with this system, and we could have some heavy showers tomorrow night, followed by some snow potentially on Tuesday as this thing starts to make its way westward. The front's probably going to lose a bit of its punch as it goes across the Mississippi tomorrow, but a line of showers and thunderstorms is going to stay intact along there. It'll be approaching our neck of the woods by 9 o'clock. There could be some heavy downpours in here, and take a note, as the cooler air fills in around this low-pressure area, it's actually what we call occluding. It catches up to some of the warm air. It modifies the air mass, so instead of being super cold, it's merely cool behind the front. So we're not going to cool down a great deal on Tuesday, but we'll break in whatever action we get Monday night. And then as a cold pool swings in, look at that. Snow showers coming back on Tuesday night, and those higher mountains could have some accumulations as well. So the drizzle stuff gets out of here. The southerly flow continues. Here comes the thunder showers tomorrow night, and some of these could be heavy. We get reds in there. They are heavy. We get some heavy gusty winds as this comes through. We can't rule out a clasp of thunder either. There's that break in the action, though. Tuesday, the temperature will be falling from the mid-40s into the 30s during the day Tuesday, and there's that snow. And we're going to have a better look at this tomorrow, though. Tonight, just some spotty drizzle. Temperatures right around 40 degrees. We're not straying too far from it. But look at this, almost spring-like. Lower elevations in the mid-60s tomorrow. Be a little breezy. And then as we head into Monday, tomorrow night, we're going to be watching that radar screen. Right around the 9 o'clock hour, we could have quite a vigorous front coming through here, and we could get some heavy rain with that tomorrow night, and maybe some very gusty winds. We're going to have to definitely have to keep an eye on that. And then Tuesday night, we got to keep an eye out for some snow. But look at the temperatures, Alexis. Not too shabby behind a strong
it's
cold front.
It's not. So
no, it's about seasonable.
So I want to be happy, but you keep talking about snow, and I want to be happy about the warm.
Well, we've been talking about snow for a few days. It's starting to look a little bit more likely for Tuesday, but once that front gets through, it's going to act like one of those clipper systems.
I just keep pretending it's not winter.
An inch or two, we can deal with that.
I guess.
Okay, it's not going to be super cold behind it.
All right.
Okay, we'll be okay with our heating bills, I think, eventually.
All right, well, thanks, Rob. The West